Well, Jeff Jarrett and China will take center stage this Sunday at Unforgiven after trading frying pan shots this past Thursday on SmackDown.
Speaking of frying pans, we have, well, maybe serve up a little sausage, maybe cook some popcorn.
Out of the frying pan into the fire.
I'm scared to death of fire, and Gangrel just loves it. Got the sunglasses on, the cauldron. I would hate to have to compete against a guy like this.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, weighing 250 pounds, Gangrel.
So Gangrel will battle the Blue Meanie here on WWF Metal as we count down the hours to Unforgiven. And I don't know, maybe there's a NOW convention somewhere in North Carolina close to Charlotte. If there is, Jeff Jarrett will be on hand probably to try to put the figure four on every woman in attendance.
I think he should put it on Patricia Ireland.
Well, yeah, of course, maybe she might be deserving of it, but I'm sure that's a fate China does not wish to have. China wants to walk out of Unforgiven, Terry, the Intercontinental Champion. So let's ask, does the Knife Wonder of the World have a realistic shot to leave with gold around her waist this Sunday?
If there's ever a quotation thing woman that can do it, I think it would be China.
Well, certainly Jeff Jarrett has got to be thinking about how he'll feel if he's embarrassed at China's hands this Sunday. I don't know what scale the Blue Meanie's getting on. It's listed him at 333, but he needs to find a new scale. He's trimmed down considerably. He looks a lot better than he used to.
He's got to be down to 323 at least.
Oh, come on. His cholesterol's never been lower. His asthma's great. Asthma.
Okay.
Doesn't need his pumper as often. Doing fantastic.
It's hard to believe that somebody that is built like the Meanie can do a moonsault off the top rope.
And Meanie used to be almost 400 pounds. He was 380 at his highest. Oh, man. Gangrel just kicked him right in his, well, less than ample midsection.
Boy, Gangrel accelerating here, picking up the pace. Maybe he thinks that if he keeps the Meanie moving, Meanie will run out of gas. Maybe backfired here, but Gangrel, one thing that has not backfired is his leadership with the New Brood.
Certainly the New Brood will take center stage this Sunday on Heat, the hour before Unforgiven. You'll see them battle Crash and Hardcore Holly. Meanie coming firing out of nowhere with a big clothesline, and now scooping a slam on Gangrel.
May I ask you a question, Kevin?
Yes.
Is the New Brood large enough to grapple against the Hollies?
I'm sure the scale that the Hollies have been seen with will be out, and there may be a weigh-in, folks, before this match. The hour before Unforgiven, live at 7, 6 Central on the USA Network.
I think Gangrel just hurt his foot. Again.
Oh! Good grief!
What has happened to Gangrel? He just opened up here, and he's annihilating the Blue Meanie.
Wow! I mean, really, just wearing out the shoe leather on the Meanie.
Do you think losing that weight has maybe drained some of the strength from Meanie?
I think the Meanie's stronger than ever. I have all the faith in the world in the Blue Meanie.
How much?
All the faith in the world! I get animated when I start talking about the Meanie. I can't help myself. Oh, man, Gangrel.
Still animated?
Following into the corner. The color's starting to wear off the Blue Meanie, so I'm not quite as animated. And of course, the Blue Meanie's longtime friend Stevie Richards, who has been a follower his entire life, a chameleon, loves to play dress up, loves to try to fit in with other people, trying to get his cool on, I guess you could say. And
yeah, Kevin, but the guy also has an identity crisis. Stevie Richards dressing up like different WWF superstars every time he goes to the ring.
Well, of course, the first time we saw Stevie Richards play dress up, it was his Gangrel, who's now buffeting the Meanie with forearms. And then most recently, this past Monday on Raw, we saw him dress up as a Dudley during the Dudley's match against the New Brood. And certainly,
Kevin?
Yeah?
You?
Don't make fun of the Dudleys now. Very physical tag team war the Dudley Boys of the Accolades will have this Sunday at Unforgiven. And certainly, the winner of that contest has got to be circling, putting a big circle around the New Age Outlaws, the new WWF Tag Team Champions.
I've circled the date on my calendar.
Which date is that, Terry?
October 11th.
Very good. Wedding bells will be ringing. What do you think about the wedding between Test and Stephanie?
Well, I'm glad
you asked. It doesn't matter what you think.
Wow.
I love doing that stuff. But Test and Stephanie's wedding is even making news on TV Guide.
My feelings are hurt, but I'm going to continue because I'm a professional.
Oh, come on, Terry. We're just having fun. That wedding event.
One of us is having fun.
That wedding event will take place October 11th, live on Raw from Atlanta, Georgia, when Raw is War invades the Georgia Dome.
Oh, I heard it's going to be covered on CNN.
It certainly is going to be a huge news event.
Listen to this.
This is CNN.
You might have a future in this business, Terry. You keep this up.
I doubt it.
Gangrel and Blue Meanie. It's breaking down into a slugfest now.
You're talking about breaking down. It looks like Meanie's starting to break down a little bit. Not a whole lot of height on that splash.
Well, the longer this contest goes, it will play more into Gangrel's favor. Wait a minute.
Shot.
Gut shot. Wow. Impaler. Man, oh, man. Center of the ring. Replacement referee man. Harvey Whippleman dispels the rumors, and he can count to three.
Here is your winner, Gangrel.
Kevin?
Yes?
Have you ever seen a referee with glasses before in your life?
No, I have not.
I think that's an admission here. I think there's a story somewhere in there.
Certainly the replacement referee is just one of the stories as we build closer and closer to Unforgiven on pay-per-view.